But Abhishek Goenka of India Forex Advisors now joins in. Abhishek, before I talk about the rupee and the dollar, what is the call on the euro dollar pair to be precise? The euro trades at a 23-month high on back of that bond purchase conversations that took place at the ECB meet yesterday. 1.16, I believe, is the level. What is the trade on the euro dollar?
I think the market is taking the European segment to be very, very hawkish. And that's the reason, even though they had not explicitly said that they're going to do QE curtailing, then still the markets have bought the euro and took it to multi-month high. So I think till the time we do not see a major correction in the dollar index overall and the sentiment changing, I think the euro is still on a buy mode. It's still on a buy on dip. And I think if it continues like this, we could see a couple of percentage higher from the current levels. But then at the same time, you have to understand that the euro has already moved close to 6-7% in the last few months. And I think we are entering into robot territory. And we might see some correction coming in within next 1-2% very soon.
Right, so I guess you're recommending that one should look at shorting the euro-dollar pair. The dollar has been on the defensive. It trades at the dollar index, to be precise, trades at a one-year low on back of course, setting action, once again moving to politics in D.C. On the dollar, how are things looking?
I think as of now, every step by Donald Trump is kind of failing. So somehow the trust factor and the point on which the entire world was basing that there would be a reflation trade has kind of come down. Because of which level the dollar is getting sold. So I think we are at extreme oversold territory in the US dollar. The levels at around 94-95 in the index is quite low. We should see a reversal sometime soon. Once we see some trigger coming out of the US, which shows that everything is not over yet, and we might see some kind of improvement happening in terms of their economic policy reforms, something on the tax or something on the repatriation of funds back to the US, then definitely we're going to see a reversal. But till that time we do not see a reversal, I think it's going to get sold on every rally, and I think 92-93 levels is the max that I'm looking at for the index.
Right. How are you playing the dollar-rupee pair? What is the range to watch out for and what is the trade this morning?
So I think, interestingly, what is happening in the last few sessions in the dollar-rupee is that despite the fact that the US dollar index has weakened to the extent of 4-5% in the last few days, the dollar-rupee is still stuck in the range of 64.30 to 64.80 levels. And I think there is extreme intervention happening from the Reserve Bank of India. I mean, they have been doing a lot of buy-sell swaps at around 64.30-65 levels. A lot of, I'm sure the reserve number is also going to be positive once we get out those numbers. There have been buying happening on the RBI on the lower side and selling happening by exporters and RBI on the higher side, because of which it's strictly on a very tight range. Now, again, I would reiterate that the volatility in the US dollar pair has come to such low levels that we're going to expect a breakout very, very soon. In case we see a reversal coming in the dollar index and the global pairs, of course, then the rupee would break on the higher side. That's close to 64.80 would break, and we would see at least 60-70 paisa move from there. But if the dollar weakness continues like this, then at some point of time, I think rupee will also get stronger. And we're going to see a break below 64. But I think there is no clarity right now in the market because it's very, very stuck in a range and there's hardly any movement in the dollar rupee nowadays.
Right, that is the call come the currency. It lacks action and that's probably the best way to describe the local currency. Don't expect too much on the dollar rupee pair. Globally, of course, the yen that's also under some pressure is seeing some gains for the second straight week. Well, thanks, Abhishek, for that. We're gearing up for market opening and it does look like